Hey, man, that was awesome. I want you guys to know something this morning, if you haven't already figured out. And I hope you caught what Alex was sharing with us. But I'm going to tell you, that guy is going somewhere. Yeah. He is going somewhere. Don't let that go to your ass. But, you know, when you start to catch those things in your spirit, you know, that God is dealing with you, and life is not all about being comfortable. Life is about letting God deal with the stuff in your heart that keeps you from stagnating, that keeps you from being stuck in a place where you are, that keeps you from moving on to where he wants you. And you know, so I just so appreciate what Alex was sharing there, that it's not about being comfortable. It's not that God doesn't, you know, give you places of rest. It's not that God doesn't give you a place where, you know, you can soak in him, but you're going to keep going back, like Alex is saying. You're going to keep going back to whether stuff in your life, things in society, that's going to make it tough. It's going to make it difficult. But that's the part about sharing in the sufferings of Christ. That's where you and I get to know him. Amen? And so, Alex stole a lot of my time there. But anyways, just work with me here. I just would like to just pull out a couple things. My heart, and we haven't forgot about the offering. We'll do that right at the end, okay? You know, everybody wants freedom. Everybody wants victory, right? Everybody wants liberty in their lives, and that's why Alex went to TC. You know, he reached a place in his life where he says, "Listen, this here. I mean, I'm not. I'm losing the battle here, and I want to win the battle." And part of what was on my heart, even before I knew Alex was going to be sharing this week, was just, you know, it's the battle for our mind. And, you know, really the battle for your mind is the battle for your heart. Because the enemy knows, amen, because the enemy knows when he can get a hold of your heart, when he knows he can get a hold of your affections and the things that you love to do, and he can get a hold of your thoughts, the way you think, he knows he can get a hold of the way you talk and the way you walk, then he can control you, right? But God has come to give us liberty. He's come to give us victory. And one of the scriptures, and maybe you can just pull it up for us there, 2 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 17. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And, you know, I'm like Alex here. I've read this so many times, and something really hit me. It actually kind of came through when I was listening to something on UCB. I don't remember what it was. But anyways, what comes, basically what's in that scripture verse about where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. What it means when you read it in this context, it really means where the Spirit of the Lord is Lord, there is liberty. Or you can say, you know, where the Spirit is Lord, there is liberty. And that's what Alex is trying to share with us in his testimony. It's like when the Lord began to deal with him, and the Lord began to, you know, work on those things in his life where he's asking, the Lord's asking Alex, the Lord's asking you and me, you know, to let him be Lord of our thoughts. You know, a lot of this stuff, you know, Alex is sharing, a lot of stuff that we deal with, you know, it happens in our mind. You know, there's a real battle for our mind. And as you know, my wife, she struggled with food allergies. I don't know, it's been about a year now, maybe? Maybe not quite a year. But anyways, and my dad always used to say to her, "Oh, well, it's just all in your head. It's just all in your head, right?" And so anyways, we ended up, as you know, we ended up going down to this program, Being Health. And we learned some good principles there. You know, it's not like they have all the answers. But we learned some really good principles there. And Anita began applying those things. But she found out that it was all in her head. But that's not just the catch, is... the thing is that when things get in our head about things, whether it's food allergies, whether it's physical, or whether it's things that you and I struggle with in our lives, is that what happens is roots start going down, and things get in our hearts. We start believing things in a certain way, and we start responding to things in fear, and that's what goes on in our life. So yes, there's things that are in our head, but the thing is, there's underlying issues, and you have to deal with the underlying issues. And once you start dealing with the underlying issues, and allow your mind to be renewed, allow your mind to be transformed because of that, then you can step into this victory. You know, we can step into this place of freedom that God has for us in our lives. But we have to deal with those things. And like Alex is saying, there's a place where you're uncomfortable in doing that. It's not easy, as Alex is saying, it's not easy to live the Christian life. It's hard to live the Christian life. But you know what? The exciting thing is you get to live the Christian life. Because when you start stepping into that stuff, when you start letting God work with you and deal with that stuff, you know, you get to step into victory. You get to see this overcoming in this area in your life. You get to see, you know, how to love your wife. Amen. You get to see how to break through and love other people in your walk. And so it's all about letting the Lord be Lord. Let the Spirit be Lord in your life. You know, when you're reading the Word, you know, let God lead you in those things. Let those things affect the way that you make decisions and the way that you walk. I think I just want to touch just briefly on Romans chapter 12 and verse 1 to 9. I think I'm just going to skip to that. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, wholly acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You know, Alex talked about, you know, being conformed. You know, he used that word a number of times about just being conformed to the things around you. And, you know, when we start allowing, you know, the situations around us, whether it's in our family, whether it's in our marriages, whether it's in our workplace, when we start allowing ourselves to just be conformed to what we think is going to be acceptable to people around us, it always results in worldly thinking and worldly ways. And you get trapped in that every time. And so it's important that we don't allow that to happen. And like Alex was saying, you know, it's not about, you know, what you think about him. It's about what God thinks about him. And it's about what God thinks about you and me that keeps you, that will save you from being conformed. So we don't want to be conformed. We want to be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is the good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. For I say that through the grace given to me, everyone who is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly as God has dealt to each one a measure of faith. The first thing to the transforming of your mind, because it's interesting how this scripture verse flows. The first thing to the transforming of your mind, it's about how you think about yourself. It's about not forgetting who you are in God. It's about knowing who you are in God. And no matter, you know, how you feel, no matter the struggles that you're going through, no matter what other people are saying to you, if God says, this is who you are, this is who you're called to be, that's what you need to pursue. That's what you need to take hold of. That's what you need to believe for, no matter what. And maybe you've heard the saying before, it's okay, you know, when you start moving ahead in things and you're trying to break out of your thought patterns and the way you used to do things, You know, it's okay to try and fail, but it's not okay to fail to try. And that's what God wants us to know, is that just start stepping forth. And I would rather die trying to live by faith than to be stuck and not move forward. And that's what God wants for each one of us. Amen? So the first thing in allowing your mind to be transformed is to think about yourself the way God thinks about you. Next scripture verse. For as we have many members in one body, but all the members do not have the same function, so we, being many, are one body in Christ and individually members of one another. The next thing in the transformation of your mind is always staying in your relationship with the body of Christ. That's the next thing, like how you are walking out your relationships with everybody here and your home, of course, too, because, you know, your family is called to be part of the body of Christ, right? That's the other part of the transformation of your mind. And I was so blessed, you know, when Alex was sharing, he was just talking about that whole aspect too, right? About not only what he thought about himself, but about his relationship. He's learning about that relationship with each of you here. And that's what we have to continue to hold on to, is because we all, there's times when we rub each other the wrong way, right? It just happens. And especially when you are working together trying to accomplish something, I mean, there's always different opinions about how to approach something, how to move ahead in something. But you just have to know in God what's your place in this function and in moving forward in it. And that's what God calls you to. And you will be blessed, you know, by just knowing what is your place, the thing that God's given you to do. And God will bless you in it. Amen?
Amen.
And so what we think about ourselves, what we think about, and how we see ourselves in relationship to the body of Christ. And I guess I just want to jump to and the overall arching thing of this, and maybe can we just jump to verse 9 there. Let love be without hypocrisy. Abhor what is evil, cling to what is good. And so the overall arching thing of all of this is about learning to love ourselves, about learning to love each other, because that's what drives this whole thing. And I just think it's so cool about, you know, when God is working in our lives, it's not, your life is not a matter of ifs. You know, it's interesting that, and I didn't give you a scripture verse back there, but in Matthew 4, we know about the temptation of Jesus when the devil came to him and tested him, right? And he said, if you are the Son of God, you know, command this stone to become bread. If you are the Son of God, you know, bow down and worship me, and I'll give you all this, you know, all the kingdoms, all the glory of the world. You know, if you are the Son of God. He kept saying, if, right? But and that's how you begin to recognize, you know, when you're hearing the enemy as opposed to hearing God. Because with God, it's never an if. God always gives you a sure word. God always gives you a word of confidence that you can move forward in your life. And so it's not a matter of if, you know, but it's a matter of what God has said about you and his call in your life. I just like to close with this thought, you know, and in the midst of our wrestles, in the midst of our struggles, you know, like Alex is saying, God often keeps us in this place of being uncomfortable, and it's not that he's trying to make us uncomfortable, it's just because we all have stuff, and we have to own that stuff, and we have to work through it. But one of the things that gets really exciting, because I'm kind of learning this stuff too, you know, same as Alex, and James chapter 1, it starts out there in the beginning about, you know, count it all joy, brethren, when you face trials of many kinds, knowing that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. You know, and it's exciting when you get to the place where you are excited about being tested. You're excited about the trial that faces you. You're excited about the Goliath that's in front of you.
Amen.
And the awesome thing, you know, if you want to go back and look at David, the interesting thing is he ran at Goliath. I don't know if you've ever taken note of that. It said that he ran towards him. And I think two things were going on there. One was because he was excited. There was a joy. He had a joy in the trial because he was back fighting the lion and the bear when he was back tending his father's sheep. And so he was getting victory there. It was preparing him for facing Goliath. And so he was in a place of excitement. He was counting a joy of being able to, you know, see this enemy that was defying the armies of God brought down. And there's enemies in your life and my life that tries to defy what God wants to do in your life. And so David ran towards Goliath. But I think the other thing he was doing there was he was, in a sense, trying to psychologically throw off his enemy, because the enemy knows that, and that's happened so often. I'm learning this as I come to the Word, just like Alex is really exhorting and encouraging us today. We come to the Word and we read it and we soak in it and we get ready and all that sort of stuff, and all of a sudden you find yourself doing something that you didn't want to do. And that's because quite often the enemy will do something to just try and psychologically trip us up. Even though in so many other ways you can be prepared, but you can get tripped up by it. And a while ago, we were at this person's house and they had this book on the shelf of Arnold Schwarzenegger. And a lot of you probably know Arnold Schwarzenegger. He was a big bodybuilder back in the 60s, 70s. And anyways, I just opened up, was reading about. But the interesting thing I took out of it, he was talking about, you know, when he was doing these muscle shows and these performances. And this one instance, he said, his opponent, or one of the other guys who was going to be in the show, before he was to go up and do all his muscle poses and everything, the other opponent came out, and he was kind of standing over there, like in an area where the light was shining on him just right. And he was kind of standing there flexing his muscles and stuff and doing that sort of stuff. And Arnold got looking at him. Wow, that guy's got pretty good pose. You know, he's got muscles. He says, I might be in trouble here. And he said, right at that moment, he said, even though Arnold had more muscle, more physique, and all that, he said he lost that show against his opponent because his opponent did something to throw him psychologically and kept him from performing the way that he needed to when he got up there. And the enemy does that so much in our life. And that's why we need to take every thought captive, you know, to the obedience of Christ. And one of those things is learning to get excited when you're facing the trials. Knowing that God's in it. God's not going to leave you to defeat. God is going to teach you something through this. God is going to strengthen you through this thing. And we all want to get to the place. And I just want to close with this. Let's get to the place where we can shout when the walls are still up. Because you know when they were standing around in Jericho, right? They didn't shout after the walls fell down. They shouted before the walls came down. And God wants us, he wants his people to be a people who, like Alex is saying, who walk by faith and not by sight. We're shouting while the walls are still up, because we know, even though the situation is bigger than us, even though some of the struggles we're facing are big, they're huge, Goliath's big, the walls are tall, they're strong, they're thick, but our God is bigger. And he's the one that you're walking with.
Amen.
So let's let God be God in us. Right? All things are possible with God. Not for God, Because yes, all things are possible for God, but they're also possible with God. He wants you walking with Him in your circumstances. He wants you shouting before the walls have even come down, because you know that He's with you in circumstance, and that you can give Him your thoughts. You can let Him control your thoughts. You can let Him be Lord. You can let the Spirit of the Lord be Lord. And the victory is yours. The liberty is yours.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So why don't we just close in prayer, and then we'll have you come up and we'll do our offering. Maybe Doug, you can just put on some worship. Actually, maybe I'll call the worship team. Let the worship team come up. And maybe you can just play a song for us while we're doing the offering. So Lord, we just want to bless you. We just thank you this morning. God, for the good things that you're doing, Father. The good things, we just thank you for Alex's testimony, God, what you're doing, what you're showing him. Thank you, God, that he's moving forward in you. Thank you that the things that you've shown him is the same things that you are seeking, God, to show us. And Lord, we're just here this morning to say, we just want you to be Lord in our lives. We just want you to be Lord of our thoughts. And Lord, we just thank you that with you, that the walls are coming down. Lord God, that with you, Lord God, that the Goliaths are going to fall. And Lord, we thank you. We can just trust you with the things that you've already shown us. We don't need the swords. We don't have to have the armor of other people, but we can use the stones that you've given us, Lord, to see the enemies in our lives fall, just as you did with David and Goliath. So, Lord, we thank you. We just bless you this morning. Lord, I pray your blessing on everyone here. I just pray that they'll just allow, God, just faith to arise, to be created in their hearts by the hearing of your word this morning, Father. And Lord, we just bless this offering that is coming forward this morning, Lord. We just thank you, Lord, just the opportunity we have to give, to share, Lord, to bless others through the blessing that you've given to us in Jesus.